steam trains, the classic machine that brought the country together, the earliest jump to industrialization, and the first creation that transcended from just another useful tool to a living, breathing extension of its own creators and operators. For well over a century, the steam engine was seen everywhere that had rails. There once was a day where whistles were heard echoing through the nights, and the air was filled with the smells of steam. But steam has served its purpose. No longer to be the kings and queens of the rails, every era has its exceptions. Our first stop brings us to Essex, Connecticut, home to the state's only regularly running steam operation. The Essex Steam Train, also known as the Valley Railroad, operates on a section of former New Haven Railroad trackage, north of Old Saybrook. The railroad is classic 1920s era, with Pullman heavyweights and branch line feel. The railroad is also one of the best maintained in the country, with over a dozen well-restored passenger cars, a growing fleet of old diesels, an eclectic collection of steam engines. One of the ones running is New Haven 3025. This engine was rebuilt following an arson fire in Pennsylvania to resemble a long-gone New Haven 282 Mikado. The 3025 is actually fairly young, built in 1989 in China. It made its debut on the Essex Steam Train in 2011, and today it shuttles passengers from the railroad station to their riverboat service. We even get a chance to ride in the cabin. The railroad's other Mikado is seen here, number 40. This engine was built in 1920 for use in logging service in Canada. It was relocated to North Carolina before winding up in Essex in the 1970s. The 40 has served the railroad regularly for, well, over 40 years. Yeah. we have shown you one of two Chinese SY or Shengyu class engines in the United States. Now we show you the other one with New York, Susquehanna, and Western 142. Also built in 1989, the engine was operated at Essex at 1647, before making the jump to mainline excursions on the Susquehanna Railroad. Today, the engine service is much easier, operating on the Delaware River Railroad out of Phillipsburg, New Jersey. This trackage directly parallels the Delaware River, separating New Jersey and Pennsylvania. The area is so narrow at some points that paralleling River Road actually touches the rail. We take a look at New Jersey's other regularly running locomotive, the Black River and Western Railroad No. 60. This 280 consolidation type operates on select weekends out of Ringo's. The engine was built by Alco in 1937 for the Great Western Railroad of Colorado and was sold to Black River in 1965. The 60 was the first to operate on the newly formed Black River and Western, operating on former Central Railroad of New Jersey and Pennsylvania Railroad trackage. These shots show the North Line to Flemington, but the railroad soon plans to rebuild their south end of trackage to Lambertville. The most popular steam tourist railroad in the continental United States is the Strasburg Railroad. Located in lush Amish territory near Lancaster, PA, America's oldest short line has been the gold standard for steam operations and restoration for the last 40 years. The railroad regularly operates 4 steam engines during the course of the year. One of them is a rare-of-a-kind 480-type locomotive, the Norfolk and Western 475. This 1906 Baldwin engine was built for branch line work on the NNW. After traveling the country between owners, the 475 was extensively rebuilt between 1991 and 1994. Since then, it has been used extensively on this busy operation. Railroad's largest locomotive is number 90. This engine was built in 1924 by Baldwin for the Great Western Railroad. It is a 210O, one of a few 10-drivered locomotives in the U.S. It arrived at the Strasburg Railroad in 1967 and has operated on the line for nearly 50 years. Both these Baldwin engines run anywhere between February and New Year's Eve, with these wooden coaches filled with passengers. And in the summer, there is a distinct chance you can see them both. Our last stop takes us to Chattanooga, Tennessee, in deep southern territory. The locomotive is Southern Railway 280 number 630. A 1904 engine built by Alco, which today is operated on the Tennessee Valley Railroad Museum. The 630 was operated off and on for the Southern Railroad, and later the East Tennessee and Western North Carolina. It was used in the Southern Steam Program for about a decade. The 630 was donated to TVRN in the 1980s and spent most of the decade in regular service there. It spent 20 years out of service for repairs, which were extensive. The 630 returned to service in 2010, and it even made a 3-year return to the mainline as part of 21st century steam. Now, the engine normally runs over 3 miles of track that takes riders over bridges and through a tunnel. Normally, trips go to Grand Junction, but today, it is the North Pole. It's also not every day you get to see a steam engine on a turntable. This has been but a small sample of the steam trains running in the United States today. We hope you have enjoyed our travels and our footage. These clips are a testament to the machines built over a century ago, or as recent as 1989. It's also a testament to the people who spend countless hours keeping these machines operating today. We encourage you to go out and see one of these locomotives in service when you can. All railroads showcased in this video are linked below. And be sure to check out Dynamo Productions for more videos we've uploaded and more to come. For now, thanks for joining us with our special Steam Trains 3.